Hey guys, this is an update on my C Cheese group build entry with the 251s, the half tracks. The vehicles are now completely finished and the figures are completely finished except for some mud effects on the guys that go outside the vehicles. The guys that go inside the vehicles are all finished and installed. There's nothing else I'm going to be doing to them. So I guess I'd call that the most difficult part of the build. The figures, anyway. For me, anyway, doing figures is always a pain in the hoo-ha. I don't like doing figures, but, they're a necessary element to telling stories. Without people, you have not much story. At least not very interesting ones. So these fellows here are gonna go and sit in a box for a few days while I work on the diorama. Diorama is a little bit cumbersome to work on. I actually can't work on it on this thing here because it's too big. It just ended up knocking all my stuff over trying to work on it. So I have to work on it on a separate table. That's a little annoying because the lighting's not quite as good. I can't see so well. But we'll get it done. I know what I forgot. I forgot these guys too. These guys are finished. BMW R12 motorcycles with sidecars that I got from IBG, they're finished too. Didn't much care for those kits. They were pretty sluggish on the detail, and the fits weren't that great. The instructions were meh. So, you know, it kind of made me wonder what the rest of the kits were like from this company. So I did a little bit of research on it, and apparently this is not one of their best. From what I've read, they have done much better. Their Scammel, which is, I guess, one of their most talked about kits, their Pioneer Scammel and their upcoming tank recovery vehicle version of it are quite well anticipated. There's another company that's coming out with pretty much the same thing, too. I don't remember the name of it off the top of my head. Both of these companies are fairly new to me. I've never really heard of them until just recently. So I wanted to see what their kits were like. So I got the Scammel quite a while ago, and I glanced inside the box, but I didn't really do much else with it. I have an idea what I'm going to do with it. But I think what I'm going to do is buy the Pioneer, or the Scammel with the trailer. From one of the two companies that are going to be putting it out. I don't know which one. So, and then I'll have a bigger idea, I guess, because apparently I don't like doing small ones. speaking of which, I got a diorama that I'm working on now that is another big one, and apparently I'm planning a third one. So some of the either a couple of dioramas or a couple of single build builds on my shelf are going to have to find a new home to make room. There's just nothing can be done about it. this one here, the 251 diorama, already has a spot picked out, so and that's not going to be a problem. But the other two dios that I have planned are, well, there's going to have to be some evictions, I think. So anyway, I didn't much care for the motorcycles, but I don't think that's a cross section of what IBG does. I think this is just one kit that didn't do very well. From what I've heard, the other kits that they do are much better, but it's still a wait and see. I know someone is going to be doing reviews of some of their kits, so I'll be paying attention to see what they can pull off. So what's next is trying to get these vehicles to fit on the diorama to match the photograph. That brings me now to my next point. A really totally awesome and hoopy frood named Han Solo in the Netherlands took it upon himself to colorize the reference photo that I've been using. Which, I gotta say, if I had that colorized photo 2 or 3 weeks ago, this would be a very different level of work, I think. The photo that he sent me made me notice all kinds of errors that I've made. There's all kinds of things I've missed. A lot of them I can fix, right? But there's some I can't, because I just couldn't see them in the original photo. My eye couldn't tell the difference between what was there and what wasn't there. And he is, I believe, a graphic designer or someone in that field. So he has access, obviously, to software that can enhance details and stuff in photographs. Because he really popped the detail on that photo. And you guys are looking at them now. But I can see a lot more because it's not just contrast that I'm looking at. It's you add color to it, and you can really see the differences between details. There's a lot of things that I noticed that I missed. I mean, one of the biggest ones is one of the motorcycles is facing in an opposite direction. I thought both motorcycles were facing against the flow of traffic in the picture, but in actuality, one's facing against it. That's the one that's furthest away, and the other one's facing towards the camera. I thought I had it the other way around, so I'm going to have to make a bit of a change there. I now have a better idea of what the lumber piles and junk piles along the sides of the road are made up of. I have a better idea of what the road is supposed to look like. Unfortunately, that one I won't be able to fix, I don't think, because mine's already made and quite solid and dry, so my road will look a little bit different. My road will probably look a little bit muddier than the one that's in the picture. And I can see a lot more of the details on the vehicles as well, which is cool, but it's also a little annoying because it shows me everything that I've missed. But that's all right. I found it fascinating. I studied that photo for quite some time, and I got to say, Han, thank you very much for that. I really appreciate the work that would have went into that, and I really, really do. I don't know anything about colorizing black and white photos, but it certainly doesn't look like an easy thing to do. I've seen some good ones and I've seen some bad ones over the time, but what you did there looked pretty good, and it certainly did make a difference when I was trying to, pick out details and stuff like that. So that was fantastic. It was an excellent change to the resources I was using. So it was really appreciated. So I also got to say thanks to another fellow who I probably won't name, who supplied me with some of the figures that are on the scene. There's actually two fellows that sent me figures, and I incorporated bits and pieces of those figure sets from both fellows. And one is an exceptionally incredible set from Alpine that I'm using. Where are they? Not this fella here. This guy. And yeah, these four guys here. Oh, just broke the barrel off that guy. I'll have to glue that back on. I keep breaking that off. These four fellows here are really exceptional figures from Alpine. Like, they're top quality. And I love working on Alpine figures. It's funny, if I'm working on a somewhat dodgy figure, it's not so great. And right next to it, I'm working on a nice, well detailed, very crisp like resin figure. The two figures are going to look different, even though I'm putting the same level of work into both of them, because the resin figure just has the crisp details that catch how I paint them better. They always look better. No matter what I do, they just look better. Like, these guys are all plastic figures, these guys in the back here. And there is just a different level of detail when you compare the resin guys to the plastic guys. And it's reflected in the paint. It just shows up better. So they're a lot more expensive, especially this set. I know this figure set, four-piece figure set, is very, very expensive. It's also a collector's item because it was hand-signed by the artist, which makes it even more so. And I know what something like that, that kind of a, I guess, donation is. And it was exceptionally generous. And much appreciated. I loved painting them. Holy cow, I don't like painting figures anyway. But when they're that good, well, it's not so bad. I can get over it. Because they were really nice, and they turned out pretty good. I do like the way they turn out when they're done. I don't know, there's something about them. I tried doing PDOT camo on them, which, it's always a work in progress, PDOT camo. Sometimes I get it, sometimes I don't. This one, I got it in some places and I didn't in others. But German camouflage is always a kick in the nuts. And unless you're a decent figure painter, it's always the one thing I don't like doing. Right? So I don't like doing German camouflage. The rest of it was all just, flat white, and that was kind of boring. It's a little bit dull to weather and stuff like that. Basically, I just gave them a dark wash, and then I dry brushed it with basically more flat white. Actually, it was a dirty white is what I used. And then I gave it another subtle wash with like a light gray just to smooth it together. It kind of worked. Painting white is tricky, so I'm still learning, how I like it to look. Not how to do it, how I like to do it myself. What else? Oh, yeah, the camouflage smocks for the guys that were dressed in summer uniforms. Regular uniforms, not so much summer. Went a little bit better than I expected. Basically, all I did was take a piece of tissue paper and cut it into a long, skinny strip, and then I cut it into like 5 or 6 equal lengths, one for each person, passenger, each soldier, and then I cut a hole in it and put it over their head. And once it was on, this is all before I painted the figures, and then once it was on, I took a paintbrush with some thin PVA and basically molded it to the figure and put folds in and stuff like that and everything. And then I let it dry. And then once it was dry, I primed the figure and I just picked out the camouflage smock with flat white. And it looks okay. The texture is a bit rough. It looks more like they're wearing like white canvas or white burlap rather than white sheets, which is what they were wearing. Actually, I think what they were wearing looked like bed sheets with holes cut in them. That's what it looked like. It's hard to tell, but they might have been tailor-made by the military for specifically the purpose of being a camouflage smock, but they still look like they're made out of bed sheets. But the ones I did, they tended to have a bit of a rougher texture. But some of the resin figures that I used that were all in white camouflage also had that effect. They don't look like they're wearing something different. At least not in the realm of this scene, anyway. But you can't see most of them anyway because they're sitting down inside the half tracks. Overall, I'm fairly happy with how they turned out. I wish the figures had fit into the half tracks better. They don't really fit all that well. I had to move some of the equipment on their belts around in order to get them to be able to sit down and stuff. And even still, they don't completely sit. And I just wish that the figures fit better and they were in a pose more closely related to what's in the photograph. But unfortunately, they aren't. And I'm not a very good figure modeler, for remodeling and stuff like that. I don't have a good eye for sculpting. I never did. I've tried my hand at sculpting many times, but there's some things I can do and some things that I just can't. And figures are, they're in the can't. I don't like my work when I do it. And I've tried quite a few times. So it's just not something I have a knack for, I think. So, but overall, so far, I'm quite pleased with how this is turning out. If I don't screw up the diorama, I think this will be an alright looking piece. It'll be weird looking from the side, I think. Not as weird as my the one I call my Creighton's Run diorama. That one looks a little weirder because it's all stretched out in one long length. But this one here, it's a little bit busier, so it doesn't look quite as strange. So hopefully, when I get it done, it'll look alright. Anyway, I'm going to probably start working on the diorama. It won't be today because I'm getting another ton of topsoil. If you're wondering why I haven't been releasing regular videos or making regular posts on my Facebook page, it's because I've been doing a lot of landscaping outside. I just finished spreading a ton of topsoil all over a giant hillside in my yard, and I'm having another ton of topsoil delivered today so I can finish it. And half of that ton is going to be used to rebuild a garden. So it's a lot of work, a lot of running around with a wheelbarrow and a shovel. So it's good for me, but it also means I can't be in here because it takes, you know, time. What else? Anything else? No, I think that's it. So again, thanks to Han and Mr. You Know Who You Are for those figures. I really appreciate it. It'll make a big difference, I think, in the end, to how this thing's going to turn out. So you made me happy. All right, guys, you guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.